Hi. Resonance is an important branch in physics. We experience resonance in many applications of our daily lives, such as radio, microwave, swing, pendulum, and so many other applications.
We all have heard about the Tacoma Bridge, which collapsed on November 1940, and the Wibbly Wobbly Millennium Bridge in London, where on June 2000, the bridge began to wobble so violently. Besides the Angers Bridge catastrophe in 1850, and some other disasters which are caused by a common phenomenon, which is resonance. Resonance is a process in which an object's natural vibration frequency is amplified by an identical frequency. In other words, all objects have natural frequency. When the input frequency matches the natural frequency of the object, there will occur amplification in the amplitude. This will cause what we called resonance. Resonance is presented in many applications of our daily lives, where it doesn't just cause catastrophes. However, scientists try to make use of this stored energy and transfer it easily whenever needed, such as in Tesla coil, which is an electrical resonant transformer used to produce high voltage, low current, high frequency alternating current electricity. Microwave, where food is heated quickly because of resonance. Radio, where when we turn the knob of the radio to a specific channel, we are changing the natural frequency of the receiver. When the natural frequency of the receiver matches the transmission frequency of the station, the energy transfer occurs and we listen to the selected channel. Now let's explain this process on a swing or pendulum example. There are two types of forces: resistive force, which causes damping, driving force, which causes resonance. Now, resistive force is always in opposite direction to the velocity, which reduces the amplitude. So as the swing or the pendulum is pushed up to an amplitude, when you set it free, the swing will oscillate and the resistance will cause it to decrease. So the sine wave will start and gets smaller with time. Now, if there was no resistance, then the sine wave will stay the same and the amplitude won't become smaller. However, in reality, the amplitude decreases with time. And this is what we called light damping. So the swing is freely stopped. Now, when you try to bring the swing down safely, the amplitude will undergo heavy damping. However, when you stop the pendulum or the swing quickly in a very short period of time, this is called critical damping. And this is unpleasant for the person in the swing because they'll feel a massive force in a little or short period of time. Now, on the other side, the driving force, which is the same direction as the velocity, speeds up and increases the amplitude. This is caused when the external force has same frequency as the natural resonant frequency. Now, another simple example where you experience resonance is the jump rope. If you rotate your arm slow or fast, the rope cannot gain a big amplitude. You can feel by yourself there is a precise frequency rotating your arm, even small force, the jump rope can have a big amplitude at. This is the resonance, and the frequency you use is the natural frequency of the jump rope. So, for the resonance to occur, external frequency should be equal to the natural frequency. Now, Angers Bridge experienced a powerful thunderstorm, which caused it to sway. The soldiers' march matched with the same cadence, which contributed to the structure, then oscillating at its resonance frequency and its ultimate collapse. The other bridges collapsed due to many factors other than resonance. For example, the Tacoma Bridge collapsed mainly because of aeroelastic flutter, which is an unstable self-excited structural oscillation at a definite frequency where energy is extracted from the earth stream by the motion of the structure. Resonance also occurred in the guitar or when singer breaking a wine glass, where if the singer's voice hits the resonant frequency of the wine glass, a transfer of energy will occur. Besides, it's presented in swing or pendulum or a music system playing on the high heavy beat, besides the radio and microwave that we mentioned before. But what about a singer breaking a glass of wine? As we mentioned before, every substance has a natural or resonant frequency, the frequency at which its own atoms vibrate. Now, a human voice producing that same natural frequency will also cause the glass to vibrate, which is the resonance phenomenon, and occurs because the singer's voice displaces nearby air particles which crash into the glass like invisible waves, and when singer's voice is amplified, these waves get more powerful. And with enough amplification, the glass can vibrate so strongly that it shatters. And this happens because when a substance encounters a frequency that matches its natural frequency, it absorbs the energy rather than reflecting it. Now, the effect of singer's voice on the glass has been demonstrated at least once, where in 2005, the rock singer Jamie Vandera was recruited by the Discovery Channel program to test his powerful voice. It took him several tries, but he was eventually able to shatter a wine glass with his unamplified singing. By the way, it's not necessary to have a loud voice to shatter the glass. Sounding at the right frequency with the proper amplification can shatter it. In other words, no matter how loud the sound is, if the pitch doesn't match the resonant frequency of the glass will reflect most of the energy and won't break. Now, sometimes there are cracks in the wine glass, which are a very small defect that starts the fracture, help in breaking the glass easily or faster. So as you start singing at the wine glass, it starts to vibrate back and forth, which put tensile stress on the crack, so it's going to stretch it, and every time it does that, maybe the crack grows by little tiny bit, and you do that again and again, many times, until finally the crack gets a critical crack length, and then, boom, you get brittle fracture.
And that was our video about resonance. Hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you're not subscribed yet, and like the video. Bye-bye!